Dear participant, very good evening to one and all. Today is on we are going to have the 57th webinar session on mental health and expressive movement therapy. For that, with us one of the psychologist from Erode, and she is on very popular in that and she's a MPhil in applied psychology, PG diploma in guidance and counseling. And she's doing freelance counseling as well as lifestyle training to various institutions and organizations. Ma'am, you can take over the session and then you can carry on.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Friends, kindly mute your mics. And you know, when the session is there, we would like you to have peaceful hearing. Really appreciate it. Thank you.
So hi everyone. Movement therapy. Sometimes it is called as dance movement therapy. In some places we call it as creative movement therapy. In some places we call it as expressive movement therapy. So let me start with what is the difference between, or what are they the same? So basically it is all the same, but according to the regions we just change it differently. That's it. But basically there is a little bit of qualification for calling about being a therapist. So dance movement therapist, so for that a qualification needed is an MA with a dance movement therapy. In India it is not very prevalent. We have certifications and diplomas in India right now, because as of now in India it is a budding therapeutic process. But we all know about certain things which has started years, centuries back, and with the basic movement. Yeah, so let's see how it is all related with mental health. So as it says, body is the vessel of who we are. So what is movement? Is it like another language? Or it is like something, a different aspect? No, it is the movement. It all started. It is what started everything. We all came from a movement, right? The universe started with a movement, the Big Bang. The world is living with lots of movements. The birds move, the planet move, everything is feeling, everything is having emotion in a different way. So when it comes to humans, we look at our body in a very different way and mind as a separate entity, right? So here in this movement therapy, we are seeing the body as the vessel of who we are. It is a tool for us. So let me begin with a quote by Virginia Satir, who's a popular American author and also a therapist. She says, when I am in touch with myself, my feelings, my thoughts, with what I see and hear, I am growing toward becoming a more integrated self. I am more congruent. I am able to make great contact with other person, and I am more whole. So, literally, figuratively, metaphorically speaking, everything is like being in touch with ourselves. So when we see mind as a different entity and body as a different entity, the touch factor becomes a different one. So that becomes a very big gap between body and mind. But whereas in this movement therapy, we see mind and body are interconnected, and it is all in a dimensional, dynamic process which is going on and on and on. So according to ADTA, American Dance Therapy Association, they say it is a psychotherapeutic use of movement to further the emotional, cognitive, physical and social integration of the individual. So all of it put together. So we are trying to make it to a integration, not only just emotional or cognitive or physical, together. That is where we are trying to make it as a therapeutic tool here. This was given by EADDA previously, and European Union had added one more aspect, spiritual well-being. So as we all know, the Western psychology and the Eastern philosophies are a little different from each other, and there is always a gap between these two. So in Eastern philosophy, we talk about spiritual well-being also. So in the recent times, this factor is being taken into account in various well-being chapters. And that is how it is also being integrated. So physical, emotional, cognitive, social, and spiritual well-being is all targeted. So in a single word, this therapy aims for a holistic development of the well-being. The sense of wholeness. As I said, this works on the premises of mind-body-spirit nexus. We say, if the mind is being treated, the body becomes okay. And if both are being in connect with each other, the spirit gets in position. Whereas, lots of different ideas and concepts which we have learned as a behavior, there are lots of taboos and a lot of stereotyping happening also. We don't see our body as one with the mind. This is where a problem comes in. If these two are in tandem, yeah, that is a different matter. If everything is being seen as a different entity, then everything goes for a toss. So the main goal, the main premise is mind, body, and spirit nexus all together working in the same way. And one more base we take it is that dance movement therapy. So why don't we call it as a dance therapy? Basically speaking, dance we choreograph, right? But here we don't choreograph. This is based on authentic movement of the body. The movement which comes out as it is, without aiming for a perfection or any expectation or any sort of regulation. It just comes out. And so by that, we are in touch with our own self, trying to be our own self without any hesitation. Here I would like to say about the dance culture we have. So in every tradition, almost all the traditions around the world, we have dance as a celebration. For each and everything, they dance. Even for a funeral, they dance. Why is that? So in recent times, not in the recent times, at least in quite some time, we have been seeing dance as an entertainment purpose or something which has to be done on one particular occasion or something like that. No, it is not so. Dance is the basic movement and a choreographed one. When I say movement, this is a movement. This is a movement. The small movement shows us what we are. The slight tap of an eyebrow, how I show my hand towards someone, how I move my body in an intimate space, or I keep away from one person or with the group. Those become a metaphor for everything. So it is not that dance, a choreographed one, is what we are looking at. This is something very authentic, which comes right away, right from the spirit. Basically, it is the authenticity we are talking about here. So what are the characteristics of the movement therapy? So what is it based on? We look into body literacy and awareness. So how does the body move? Are we aware of the body anatomy? Anatomy in the sense, not in the cellular level, but at least, what is my body based on? Do I know each and every part of my body? Am I in connect with that particular part of the body? And being aware of it every moment, or whenever it is necessary. So that is what is all about body literacy and awareness. A lot of my clients especially the adult ones, they say, so far I have not felt that I had so many body parts in my body. And it will be very interesting when they explore through different movements. There are a lot of movements are introduced in a very different way, where they're like, they'll feel like I'm feeling so alive, as if it's my new body. So until that point of time, their body literacy level and the awareness will be very, very poor or very low. So that is very interesting to see that. So to start with that, we look into the body literacy and the awareness. And next comes the integration of the body, mind and the spirit. So this is like a last process of the therapy, but still I want to amplify it, because every single time I say this, it is always we are going back to that. It's a mind, body and spirit nexus. And aid to verbalization. We have a lot of therapies, a lot of talk therapies we have, drama therapy, play therapy, so many therapies. So conventionally, we had been going on with the talk therapies, quite few people are not comfortable in talking about their emotions and feelings in a very open manner, or sometimes their articulation level will be a little lower, their hesitation, sometimes a vocabulary problem, all those things are there. So what happens, this movement, as it is a natural one, this aids in verbalization. Once the body is free to move, and they are able to show what is happening inside their body, and they feel very free from inside out. So this becomes an aid to verbalization. It leads to verbalization, because we start with the non-verbal and it becomes verbal at the end of it. So there is an improvement, there is a development in the non-verbal part also and the verbal part also. And this is a developmental in nature. So some clients, they don't start with moving. They don't even want to move. They just have to sit. They want to sit. They just want to say, I will just see. I will just be here. So with that dot, from that dot, it becomes a flow. And that is where the therapy leads to. And even within them, there will first of all, even with their own body, as I said before, some people don't know, oh, yes, this patch I have not felt or so far. And they would not have been intimate with their own body. So at that point, when they're going through the movement therapy, they will go into the exploration of what is this particular body part showing, doing, how can it move in different ways? Can I bend? Can I move? Can I do this? Can I do that? Or should I be like this? Or can I do this in a different way? So that sort of exploration happens. Innovative. So once it starts happening, the movement becomes different, and there is an improvisation happen there, and unpredictable. Because there is no expectation, there is no structure or choreographed movements, they're all very unpredictable. And it is okay. We need to enter into the session with an open mind, with definitely no judgments about it. Everything is okay. There is no right or wrong in this. This is how we work with movement therapy. Identification of bizarre movement. In certain incidents, when the client starts sharing, when they enact it, when they embody it, or when they see it done by a different person in a group therapy process, they will see, oh, this is how I've been doing. Was I so bad? Was I been doing this, which really did not hit me at all until I saw this right now? So this was very different for many people. So they identify all those confusing or a sense of clarity moment also. There is a cerebral analysis happening inside. All the neural pathways change because they are starting to explore and do most of the things. This is seen as an unexplored medium of expression. So we generally go with the dots. Here they have totally a free expression over there. They don't need to talk, absolutely silent. They can be sitting and showing what they feel also. They can be lying down on the floor and they can do whatever they want to. It is simply an unexplored, but a very interesting medium of expression. And finally, it is not just all these integration and awareness. It is also a celebration of all these mind, body, and the spirit nexus. Not only a nexus, but also the separate parts, separate aspects of it. So this therapy is called as bottom-up therapy because here the healing starts in the body first rather than thinking. Thinking happens at the last, but the healing starts with the body. We concentrate on the feelings and emotions in the body level, the sensations, the emotions coming out from different parts of the body or the body as a whole. What happens? It soothes the nervous system, calms the fear response situated in the lower part of the brain. So once this is happening, the upper end, the thinking will happen in a very different way so that the neural pathways, as I mentioned before, so it will be streamlined in a very healthy way. So for whom this is? This is for everyone. There is no particular population for this. It is not just for children or it is not just for adults. It is not just for a particular population of patients. No, this is for everyone. And trust me, everybody enjoys this, especially the kids. So when it comes to kids, this is their natural movement. This is their natural language. Yeah. So because this therapy has not just movement, movement in the sense we do play, we do dramas, we do a lot of crayon works, coloring works, making up artworks also in this. We do music also, like drumming, making a symphony of vocals, like a choreography. They come up with all those things. So what happens? They are free to move. They are free to express. They come up with their originality. All those original ideas come out without hesitation and they are ready to accept it, whatever. And the crowds also cheer it. So it is a very win-win situation for both, whoever is seeing also, whoever is, as a population in the group therapy I'm talking. And even in individual therapies, it works very well because some of them wants to do it individual and it also works. Once certain individuals starts okay with this therapy, we try to integrate them into group therapy. So what are the different techniques we use? We use mirroring. We are seeing our faces in a mirror every day, single day, right? How the mirror shows our face, like the right hand, if our right hand goes up there, it shows the left hand. Like that, we use the same thing with the participants. If it is an individual method, it is an individual session, the client and the therapist do this mirroring, or if in a group process, they will be paired or done with the trio or even with the group. So the movements will be mirrored for the client to know what is that they are doing, what is it they are undergoing, to give it in a different perspective so that a different point hits them. So how do we progress about it? So from the therapeutic point of view, we have something called movement analysis, how we have tools for assessment and everything. We have something called Laban analysis, where we look into something called BESS, the body, the effort, the shape, and the So all the four. So how the body is moving, where it is moving, when it is moving, and what is the effort being put into there? Is there any type of construction which will happen over there in a different way? So when the client can move only in this level, and that is one analysis we are doing. It is like vertical movement or a horizontal movement, whether they are using the whole space. What is the shape of them doing that? There are different shapes in which the clients move, and that is also a pattern for the behavior in their outside world. So this is one type of analysis which we do on Laban. There is another technique on imaginative, we all know, in a movement way, meditative techniques. And there is very interesting called life journey. So typically I start my sessions with life journey, wherein we start from the conception point or just before the delivery point to this day. So the individual sees what is their life journey through the movements without even uttering a word. And that is how they get into their own world by feeling, by sensing what is happening inside them. And thereby, it becomes a warm pool sometimes. It becomes a sharing for a pleasantness sometimes. So all these things come out through their life journey. It's a very interesting technique which we use. And we look into rhythmic synchronicity. When the client goes to the group, when a person works with a group, so we look into the synchronicity with the group, whether they are moving with the group, whether they are able to get what they want to with the group, all those things will be matter. So the synchronicity, not only with the group and within their own self, also matters a lot. Kinesthetic empathy and awareness. So kinesthetic, the movement basically, the body wise here. So how much of empathy they have towards themselves? That is one. How much of empathy they are showing it to the other people in the group? That is also being looked into, because here we are looking at the social integration also. And if that is not being seen, they cannot work it out on the outer world. The mundane life, they have to look into that. They need to be in touch with their own empathy, being empathetic to their own needs, being resilient to that, being a supporter of that, and be able to support the other people's emotions and feelings and whatnot. And that awareness has to come within also, and it has to come at the end of it also. There is something called improvisation. So typically in a session, we go into movement improvisation. So we start with one movement, and one by one, the group starts to pick over from one particular movement, and they keep on going around and around and around. But one movement gets improvised by the next person and passed down to the next person. And when it comes to the same person, it would have been a different one, and they keep on improvising it. This is one technique. And in the improvisation, we do different kinds of techniques also. So what are the different tools we use here? So the main tool we are investing here is the body. So when we enter into this therapeutic space, we ask the client to be open. We ask the client to be ready to improve their ability to invest their body in this. Everything goes in, they are feeling what they want to feel and express what is that they want to get it out also. The next is music. Not many people will be happy without music. And typically some people are like, yeah, I would like to move only when there is music. And music is a stimulator, it is a supporter and an initiator also. So we use therapeutic kinds of music in order for them to feel at ease, to be with themselves, to be open with the space also. So it is an enhancer here. At times, we don't use music. Safe space. it is a therapist's work to hold the space in a safer way. As we all know, it is when it comes to therapy, it is very much necessary. And for movement therapy, we invest in a very large space so that the clients are ready to move, because in kinds of certain attributes, certain incidents which they want to enact, embody, they want to run around in places. So in kinds of certain dreams, if I could say, there are people who have enacted their dream by running around the whole space, and they want to run and run and run in a very big space. That becomes cathartic for them by itself without even telling anything. So a big space, which is very much necessary. And different props we use in this, as you can see here, we use color pencils, papers, and we use scarves, dupattas, soft balls, musical instruments. There is one colorful thing which I've laid down there. It is called Octaband, which I use it. Trust me, this is being loved by adults more than the kids. I'm not saying kids don't like it, but they love it like anything, and they go on and on for hours together. Thereby, those hesitancy come out. And they're free to move. They want to move it without anybody telling anything, because there should be no judgments, right? And we enter into this space keeping in mind that no judgments at all. There is no body shaming or no nothing. Just an open mind to work on oneself. So we use different tools like this also. So this is to enhance. This is to make them show what is that they feel like also. Sometimes when I show this, when I keep it in, the adults will take it and keep on doing this. Trust me, more than the kids, they keep on doing this without anything. So there is no structure for this. They keep on doing that. This is one example. A singing bowl would do. We use in a very improvised way also. So coming to benefits. N number of benefits, as you can say. So starts with stress reduction. We know whenever we get a chance of dancing, we dance, right? Given a chance for 1 minute, if nobody is there, we'll just keep on dancing until someone turns up, right? So at that moment, we feel so alive. All the dopamine and serotonin just goes up. And we know about dopamine and serotonin, which the dopamine reduces the anxiety, and the serotonin boosts up so much of our physical aliveness. And because of the imbalance of the serotonin, we get into lots of disorders. We get into OCD, anxiety, panic attacks, depression, a lot of anger. And these are being dealt with when we just move ourselves. So to start with, it's a stress reduction. It's a stress buster. This is prevention. So we have a lot of line sentences towards this. An apple a day keeps the doctor away. I would say 5 minutes a day, dance will keep everything away from you in a very different way. And mood management. Yes, everybody loves dance. Everybody loves music. Nobody says, no, I don't like music at all. In any form of music, we get into ourselves. Be it Carnatic, be it folk, be it rap, be it pop, be it a Darbuka, whatever it is. Yeah. So it's such a mood manager. Promote self-awareness. So what happens? We get to know ourselves inch by inch, body-wise, and the connected feeling and emotions. Thereby, the gap prevailing is being bridged up. So we get to know ourselves in a better way, in a very deeper way also. And thereby, we know, we become confident. So our self-esteem goes up. And because it is a safe space, we get to express our own feelings and emotions, which are being festered inside our body for a very, very long time. Yeah. If I could ask you people, how many of you feel body pain when you are going through stress? How many of you would raise your hands? Almost everybody. For some people, it will be here. Some people, it will be here. Some people, it will be here. Some people, they can't talk. The block will be here. Some people, even here, there will be a block. Sometimes it is in the solar plexus. For some people, in the legs. So it differs from person to person, right? So the feelings and emotions goes into the body and it becomes an invested space, a growing field for the negativeness inside us. So the body becomes tightened because of all these anger, let's say, for example, anger or sadness. You can go through it just by looking into some of the incident. Even when you look into the incident, even when you reiterate into an incident, you know, even when I just remember it, it comes here. It comes here, there, and everywhere. So it has to be released. We think that it is all stored in the mind. No, it is not only there, but it is also stored in the body. And when we don't look into all those things, after a long period of time, it becomes a disease for us. Because we are the one who are not letting it go. We are keeping it inside, becomes a field for the growing disease. Moving on to the next one. Regaining the healing force, thereby the life force gets stimulated. So whatever we had as a hurt, as a trauma, when we move, it gets released. The body cells, the tissues gets repaired. The healing force enters into our body. So then the life force, the spirit's life force gets stimulated. So what happens? Everything is being stitched up again. And thereby we are becoming a new person altogether. Creates new memories and neural pathways. Because we are releasing all those negativities from our body, so what happens? A new memory is being created. At the end of one incident which is being released outside, we are seeing it outside, we are getting a new perspective, and what happens? We are going into a new dimension of looking at that incident. And the neural pathways are being stimulated. Integration of mental, physical, emotional, spiritual aspects of life. I would like to say one thing about this. This is not very easy. This is not very tough also. This comes with the practice for a long time. Or in some people, it becomes very easy also because of the consistent practice they have by moving themselves, moving mentally, moving physically, moving emotionally, and moving spiritually also. It is not just physical movement alone. So, steps. So, to start with, what can we do? State shift, I would call. Just put on some music which lightens up your mood. Just go on with it, dance it out. So the body doesn't lie. When it says, so many people are there, but I don't know how to dance. Just shell it out. Just dance. Don't mind about whether people are going to judge you, whether they are going to say something bad about you. No, you matter. So you give that importance to yourself. Just keep moving. Mobilize your body. So movement is just through dance alone? No. It is a lot of techniques we use. One is dance. There are a lot kinds of dances, different dance forms you can use, you've known all through your life. And there is yogasana. Yes, that is one part. There is a lot of mixed martial arts, which integrates dance also, like the capoeira, which is an Afro-Brazilian dance form. It's a Brazilian martial arts dance form also. So you're integrating that. So you have to mobilize your body. So enhance the movement of your body on a whole level. Just don't sit and say, yeah, I am moving it. No. So slowly to start with, start moving in one way and enhance it. the permission you have to give it for yourself. So looking at other people, oh, my mother will think like that. What will my father? Friends will think like that. This is, I'm talking just for the dance or moving your body alone. Just go with it. Simple as that. And the next point, being in charge. So we say that, oh, I will control my emotion. I have to control. That is a learned behavior, which is totally not acceptable. You ask for yourself, do you really want to control it? Even for a simple dance or to go into a therapy like this, just keep moving. You be in charge of your own body, whatever goes inside, as a food, as a dance, as dress, whatever it is. You be in charge. Don't give the control to anybody else. So that is the basic point which we arrive at the end of all these sessions. So becoming in charge, becoming responsible for what we are doing is the important aspect of this movement therapy. Trusting your authentic true self. So I always tell, be authentic, be yourself. Don't worry about anything else. Whatever comes from within, you want to cry it out loud, cry it out. You want to scream, you want to howl, whatever you want to do, cry it out, howl, scream all at the same time, roll in the floor. Yes. So this gives the permission for the clients. Okay, I am feeling safe here. So this is the space for me to do however I want to show it in terms of my expression. They take that permission. It is not that I am giving the permission. I say that these are the permissions available for them. They have all the choices to make. And they take the choices. They trust their instinct. They trust their authentic movement and they show it out. The true colors will come out very nicely also. And at the end of it, trust me, there is a sigh of relief and a smile which comes from them saying, oh wow, I just can't believe I've been holding this for so long. And this is totally absurd. I was taking it for a long time. Just one simple move, I just got it out of my chest. Now my chest feels like chest, not like a dustbin. This is one statement I got it from a participant in one of my workshops. So this is like that. Let the body speak and start listening. When it asks, okay, see, you have to just listen. When your hand wants to move like upward or sidewards, just do it. Don't matter about, okay, will the other person talk anything bad about me? Okay, let me do it small. But your body will be asking, move, you idiot. I want you to move me. Just go with it. You know what happens when we don't attend to it? It just keeps on asking and asking and asking. And it gets manifested as a big pain in the hand or the shoulder. Then only you'll realize. But we go into a different aspect of it. Like, I did something to my hand. But in the first instant, the body shows the symptom. Yeah? And in one sense, I would say, the movement therapy is based on one other premises, bridging the conscious with the unconscious. So the unconscious shows a lot of symptoms, messages through our body only. If we can see, all our dreams are messages. The unconscious is putting up in a different way. So how many of us put an importance to that? It tries to show it in a very nice way initially. And slowly it starts to manifest in a medial pain and slowly it becomes a big pain, finally leading to a disease, right? So when you listen, when you look into that, your body is always giving up something. Just listen to it and start giving it what it wants. That is very much necessary because here we need to understand our body is a very important tool. Be it we talk about the Western psychology or be it the Eastern philosophy, both speaks with the same term. in a very different language. So, but the basic concept is body is a very important tool for us to do anything and everything. So it is high time for us to invest our support for our own body. Yeah, sometimes it starts speaking in terms of food. Oh, this is the food I want to eat, and eat me in this way, and we wouldn't even listen to it. Yeah, so what happens? Then it becomes a very different case. So most of us know about this. Some of the awareness came to me after I went on to certain sessions only. It is not very tough to do that. So that is what I would suggest. And the last one, I would say, you can attend the EMT workshops and sessions to get a first party experience. Whatever I'm telling from here is a third party knowledge. Yeah. It is from my experience I'm talking. It is experience I've gathered from my facilitators. It is experience I've gathered from my participants. But for you to understand what it is, you really have to go in and see what it does to your body, what it does to your mind. This is very, very important. So it can be a resolution for you in your 2020 after all these lockdown and everything. I'm very sure in this lockdown, we are into this one space of our house. We are not going out or moving out a lot, actually. So a lot of anger, frustration, irritation, sadness, everything has been pent up inside. Sometimes you would have just got into a tantrum, a scolding or a fight. But just ask yourself a question. Did you move? No. If that is your answer, immediately after this session, please go and put on some music and dance. Yeah. So Shima was already dancing. That's very good. Yeah. So get an overall sense of well-being through dancing it out. It is not just dance, dance. It is moving. What moves you? You move. Are you being moved or you are the mover? Ask this question for yourself. So when do we dance? When do we have to move or dance? Only when we are happy? No. Move when you're happy also. Move when you're sad. Move when you're angry also. Move when you want to be silent. Move when you want to move and keep on moving. Yes, and thank you.
Yes, thank you, Shiva. I think when you see the comments itself, you can able to find out.
I'm sorry, I didn't see the comments.
Thank you so much, ma'am. It's very useful to us. Thanks.
Dance starts the moment we are conceived in the womb of a mother. The movement starts from there. So it's an innate thing to a human being. And whatever the emotion, we always relate it to some sort of movement. Whether we are aggressive or we are happy, it's a dance of joy or anything. Even when we are sad as well, we want to just sit down or just get into whatever it is. We always relate it to movement. That was really very enlightening session. We have we express our gratitude from bottom of our hearts. We have a few questions from the participants who are eagerly waiting to know more about this. I'll call on one by one so that you can answer their queries.
Yeah, sure.
First one is Upali Srinivas, sir. Yes. Hello.
Hello.
Ah, yeah. Good evening, madam.
Good evening, sir.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes, hello. Sir.
Are you hearing me?
Yeah. Yes, we can hear you. Please go ahead.
Yes. Madam, really, it's a very wonderful session, but I have one clarification. It's not a question or it's not a doubt. Sometimes when we have some mental pressure due to work or any other things,
yes.
How can we all those solve all those things within a day, because it is very difficult to come out from this.
So there is this one secret I would like to tell everybody. This is very easy. Just connect with your breath. Very immediately you feel somewhere you are getting into anxiety, you're getting into some sort of palpitation or anxious or fear, whatever comes up, even when you are angry and happy and getting overwhelmed, just connect to your breath. Take some deep breaths, at least 5 to 10 very slow deep breaths. So that will bring you back to the normal and also regulate your body and the mind. And you can take it as a consistent exercise in a day for like at least 3 or 4 times for 5 minutes. So as soon as you get up in the morning for 5 minutes, okay, after you empty your stomach, go sit with your spine straight and observe your breath and slowly deepen it. Very slowly deepen it and very slowly exhale it. And keep observing only this. Just 5 minutes of this consistently, at least for 30 days in the morning before you go to bed and in between any time you want to do, just do it, keep on doing it. Not only in the times of getting anxiety or anger or whatever it is due to any pressure or stress or anything. You make this as a practice, then you can see it brings a balance whenever you start going, shifting to that anxious level. Immediately you know you will bring you back to your breath and being grounded also. I hope I answered your question.
Thank you.
And this is being explained in all our Eastern philosophies. I'm sure you will know.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir. Our next question is from Hannah John. Hannah? Hannah John?
Good evening.
Hello.
Are you able to hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Dance is a nightmare for people like us. So how to begin? To begin a simple step.
Don't look at it as a dance. You just have to let it out what you are having inside immediately. Let us do one thing right now. Yeah? Please have your hands free. If you have your mobiles, just keep it down and keep your hands free. Yeah, keep your back straight. Sit straight and keep your back straight. Just roll your shoulders like this so that your body gets aligned with yourself. Yeah. Now, I want you to feel your spine by slowly starting moving from your neck down. So slowly like this and move your spine like this. From the top to bottom till the end of your spine. Just like a snake in a very slow motion. Yeah. Move your spine, move your butt also if you want to sense your butt, sense your tail end of your spine. So move it and slowly breathe. Inhale and exhale. And now raise your hands along with your inhalation and slowly bring it down with your exhalation and inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. And to the right side of you and to the left side of you. Move your spine along yourself. Move your spine, your right and to your left. So now up and down, up and down, and right and to the left, and to the right and to the left. And here you are, you danced, you moved.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, and thank you so much. So that was real fun for all of us. So whoever were upright and bold, no, they have loosened up their muscles and everything. Ma'am, next we have a question from Shubha, ma'am. Shubha, ma'am.
Hi, Shiva.
Hi, ma'am.
How are you?
I'm good.
Nice to see you through this webinar. Actually, I would like to ask you a question. This therapy, is it useful for people with severe mental disorders?
Not to a great extent, because there needs a sense of perception of their body also, and there is a level of fitness that needs for them to move. So patients with severe psychotic disorders, they're very restricted and sometimes dangerous also, so they cannot move. So this is one.
Yeah, is this used for mentally retarded, trainable, group?
Yes.
For learning concepts? Can we use this?
Yes, yes, very much we can use it. I trained a person with mild autism, and it was a success in a way where he got to express, at least he wanted to smile in a very nice way, and at the end of 12 sessions, he started smiling. It is a very tedious job, but it can be done over a period of time. Yes, very much. And especially children with learning disorders, they love this. I have trained people in learning children with learning disorders with a lot of movements. And trust me, they learn math very easily with all the movements. Just let's say, like, if we take one, we are writing in this very small way on the board. But when we move like this, one, using our whole body as a tool, they look into like at an R and it gets registered. When they start moving, it becomes a muscle memory for them. So the muscle memory never fails. Even when we try to forget, it never fails. And it is a very nice tool.
The third question is about movement profiling. You use it in therapy, movement profiling. Could you just tell about what is that?
Yeah. So as I said, we use Laban movement profiling. So wherein we see how is the body parts working as a whole and as parts. One, which body parts is the client using more often, and how, in what shape, in what sizes, and is the person putting on effort to use it, to move their body without asking or without telling more times? Even in the first instance, are they putting in their effort to do it? And how much of the space is the person using? Which levels are they using? Which dimension are they using? Are they using only 2Ds or 3Ds or everywhere? Are they using objects? Are they touching other people? So how much of a touch? Are they clinging on to something? How much of voice they are using? Like some clients, they will shout, scream. Some clients will always stay silent. So on basis of all these, we profile them.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Next, we have Prasanna, who wants to ask a question. Prasanna, are you there?
Yeah, ma'am.
Yeah,
ma'am, every therapy have some, like, some VKD, some therapies, they have some specific curable, like phobia, like traumatic experience. Likewise, these therapy will any curable. So curable means like some traumatic experience.
Yes.
So likewise, is it curable or some kind
very of? Very much, very much. I know people who work only with the trauma patients.
Okay.
So one of my facilitators, she is in Nepal. She in the border of Nepal, India, China, and she works with the people only with the trauma patients, trauma adults and children also. She has a foundation which works only for trauma.
Okay, ma'am.
And in a way, I would like to answer this question in a different way also. Trauma is like not only like a very severe, like a natural calamity, which becomes a trauma for everybody. Even for a child, if the mother or the father says, no, you should not say this, that becomes a big trauma for the child. And that becomes a scar. So I would say like everybody has been a victim of trauma in a way. And big traumas, yes, they can be, there is a lot of healing process towards it. and everybody carries trauma, and it is all healable.
Emma, my next question. Ma'am, is there some kind of NLP techniques like VKD, some techniques have some certificate, need to do some therapy? No, means we have need the certificate, but this therapy is need certificate or say anybody can do?
For facilitating, for being a therapist, yes, we need certification. It is very much necessary. Therapy is not a child's work, right? Yes,
okay.
Because we need to do a lot of work, internship, lot of research on this. Yes, definitely.
Okay,
at the minimum, there should be a certification for this.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much.
Ma'am, next we have Edwin Robert with his question. Edwin,
yes. Hello.
Please go ahead.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Hello, I'm Dr. Edwin from Coimbatore. Are you able to hear me, my voice?
Yes, we can hear you. Please go ahead.
Hello. Is any therapy for mind wellness? That means sometimes automatically my mind gets into thinking some negative thoughts. How are we going to do in the future? How we should be settling life like that? Something. So here in my home, there is no space for, there is no proper air, somewhat in some tight situation. Is there any relief for that, mental relief or therapy for that?
Definitely. As I said before, just put on some music and dance. You'll just release everything. Simple to start with, yes. Like a prescription, I would say 10 minutes of dance every single day. That would do. At the start of the day, at the end of the day. That is more than enough for you to go ahead, because everything is being released out. So you will get a clarity of mind to what is happening inside you and what can be done, what are the choices you have, which is all lined up before you. So thereby you get a choice to see and do what you want to do.
Okay. And sometimes sleeping also, most of the time not coming till around midnight, 2 o'clock. So like that.
Sweat it out, sir. You need to sweat. Simple.
Hello?
Your body is telling you to move a lot. You have to sweat.
Yeah, yeah.
The sweat
has
to come out.
Yeah. That is the thing. So I need some physical exercises.
Definitely.
Before lockdown, I went to gym. Going on, proceeding to a gym. Nowadays, it is not so. There is no chance for going to gym also.
Okay.
So these things are only by means of dance. Or
there is a difference between dance and going to the gym. In the gym, we are. What are we doing in the gym? Actually, can I ask you, like, why are you going to gym?
For shaping my body. That
exactly.
Is,
so how is that getting shaped done?
Giving exercise for each and every parts of the body.
Yeah. Muscles are getting?
My metabolism is increased. To increase my metabolism and get muscles to be tightened.
Exactly. So you're tightening yourself in the first place. So your body is getting tightened, your mind is also getting tightened.
Yeah.
So you have to do the opposite. You have to loosen it up.
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
Yeah. Simple. It seems simple, but it is the best and the practical way of getting it out.
Okay. That is only by dancing or some other yoga. Like that.
Yes, you can very well do yoga, sir.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Both yoga and dance, yes. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. We have questions in chat as well. I'll go through. Varsha Jain wants to know, like, other than dancing, is humming or singing and laughing equally useful? I mean, like,
they are different. They are other different tools of maintaining our sanity, I would say. And yes, they are useful. But even in singing, we will sit in the place, thereby not everything is being released, right? So this part, right from your abdomen area to your vocal level, it is all getting worked up. And what about the lower part? You're not giving any work to that lower part or the extremities of our body, right? Here we do all the movements to work out with inside out. That means inside till the extremities. Even with till the fingertip, we would like to explore. So we will say this fingertip is like only one. No. We will just inch centimeter, millimeter by millimeter, we keep on exploring it to see and sense what is happening inside us. So literally we have to move. Yeah, those are complementary. Yes, you can go ahead with that, but move.
Thank you, ma'am. We have Insia Karachiwala with a question. Can you please go ahead, ma'am?
Yeah, hello.
Yes. Hello.
Yeah, I'm from Mumbai. So, actually, I just wanted to know that, like, say, if a person is suffering from constant migraine, headaches or, body aches, so is it a person undergoing stress or some any other metaphysical reasons associated with that?
There can be biological causes also, but 99.99% of the diseases are psychosomatic.
Okay.
So there is some hidden things which need to be healed inside you, which is really giving you a lot of trouble, I would say. That is how it is coming out as a migraine. Recently I had one of my friends who went through this migraine problem and
okay.
We gave the therapy for her and it healed. So that needs to be a movement. And that will take a little bit of time also for you to heal. So I would really suggest you to go meet a therapist.
Okay, so hypnosis work in this case?
I am not an expert in hypnotherapy or anything, so
okay.
I can talk only for my movement therapy.
Okay.
Yes, hypnotherapy works in quite some cases, but I don't know about whether you have undergone it or not. I don't know.
Okay. Yeah, I have done my course in hypnosis. I've not completed totally, but I'm not actually not practicing it. So I've just learned. I need to practice it.
Oh yeah, please do that.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am. We have a question from Chandrachudan, sir. Sir, can you please go ahead with your question? Sir, Chandrachudan, sir.
Chandrachudan from Mysore.
Yes.
Ma'am, frequently I get cold or sinus. Will it be helpful for me to overcome this sinus
Definitely.
With the help of this movement therapy?
Definitely. Along with some physiological process, you will definitely okay. get healed.
Ma'am, one more information, please. Since I'm closer to Bangalore, where we can learn this movement therapy in Bangalore? Any idea?
In Bangalore, there is an organization called the SIMTAI, Creative Movement Therapy Association of India. They are giving out a certification and there are lots of workshops going on in Bangalore. So you can attend.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Next, we have a question from Bhuvana. Bhuvana, ma'am, can you please go ahead with your question?
Good evening, Dr. Vidhi, ma'am.
Yeah, good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, ma'am. Shivapriya.
Yeah, yes, ma'am.
Very interesting session. Very okay. interesting one. You were just answering that sleeplessness. That time I was disconnected. So will you please repeat that for sleeplessness night?
Yes. There are a lot of things going on inside the body and which is okay. not being getting rested. And that is why your okay. body is not able to sleep. So those okay. are the deep issues which really need to be solved out.
Okay.
Yes. So. Sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, please.
Yeah, please. So those, only when those issues are solved, the toxins from the body will get released.
Okay.
At that point of time, you will start sleeping without even you knowing it.
Okay.
A lot of restlessness with certain issues which keeps you away.
Okay.
Shiva, yeah. If you don't mind, switch on the light, dear.
Yeah, 1 minute.
Yeah. So what should I do for that, ma'am?
1 second, ma'am. The expert will come in a few seconds.
Yeah, thank you.
It's about to rain, so it's not getting darker. I hope I answered your question, ma'am.
Yeah, what should I do for that? I can't understand.
Please approach a therapist to solve out your issues, ma'am, first.
Oh, okay.
And you can combine with some biological process of taking some cardamom milk at the night also to soothe your nerves, so that it helps you out in resting peacefully sometimes.
And I don't follow the last word. What sentence?
Elaka pota pal irukinga illa adu.
Okay.
Ma'am,
we have two more questions. One is, what is kinesiotherapy? How different is it from EMT?
I'm not very sure about kinesiotherapy, but it is all body works, I would say. So there are a lot of body work processes which happens throughout the world. There is a Feldenkrais method, there is Alexandria method. So same way kinesiotherapy method. I'm not very, I may get back to you about the details. I cannot answer that question right now.
Okay, thank you. Last question is from Lochana Suresh. This question many have asked in regards to the courses that are available. And Lochana Suresh ma'am, can you please go ahead with your question?
In Chennai, I live in Chennai. So any this courses available by any institute here in Chennai?
Yes. There is a center called East West Counseling Center.
Okay.
They, along with WCC, are giving out a certification, Expressive
okay.
Arts Therapy. You
okay.
can enroll in that in Chennai.
Okay.
That is
okay.
the only institution which is giving out a diploma in arts therapy. Yes.
Okay, East West Counseling, is it?
East West Counseling Center. You can inquire with the WCC also.
Okay, they, okay.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. Lovely session.
Thank you
so much, ma'am. Participants, kindly send your feedback or any queries to mywebinarfeedback@gmail.com. Thank you for showing your love and support. Keep doing so. And thank you, Shiva ma'am, for having a wonderful session on dance therapy. Now, I hope today night everyone is going to have a gala
yes.
time at their home.
Yes, wonderful.
Lockdown period.
yes.
I hope so everyone would shut down their inhibitions and get their inner child out and dance to the tune of life.
Don't even think about the inhibition, I would say.
Yes.
Just dance. Yeah.
yes. Dance is sort of, life is a music and you can dance your own way into it. I thank Suresh Kumar sir for giving a wonderful session. Now I request Shubha ma'am to give the vote of thanks.
Shivapriya is a very good friend of mine. We have been into more than 7-8 years now. I think we're meeting after 8 years. Thank you, Shiva, for being a wonderful resource on EMT. Okay, expressive art therapy is, we all know, and also dance movement therapy is another. And you are infusing ED, TS is very fantastic. And we all really learned, and we know that little bit of dance and movements and kinesiology helps us to remove all of our stress stored. And this was a very systematically, given both the details and how it can scientifically also works for us. And this therapy could be done in our own level. It need not be actually, you can see experts, unless it is required, we need not see any therapist as such. So fantastic. And I really appreciate you for your answers also. Thank you so much, Shiva, for accepting. And we hope to have you again with a little more practical session. So probably we can do an mobile moving therapy kind of webinar once, so that it will be in a flow and we all enjoy it together along with you. Thank you so much, Shiva.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. This is one thing I really wanted to explain to a lot of people, because basically I'm a dancer. So I've combined therapy and dance so that I can go on with my own fun. So, and I really want people to do it also. So it's the primordial thing within each and every one of us. Yeah, please keep that in mind. It's a very primordial, like the sound OM. It is very much primordial to every one of us. Thank you so much. It's been such a nice place and a pleasure meeting you, all of you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. I thank Suresh also on this occasion that he has started this webinar. It's successfully going. We are now reached at 57th or 58th, isn't it? So it's keep growing, running, and the momentum. We just started with the like-minded team, and it's really spreading very fast, and people are joining. Please suggest a few therapists whom you have come across, or a resource person, or who have done a research on something very new and which is contributing for mental health of individual. That too with this lockdown period, it will be really a great help for all of us. And it is not that for us, it is we are for everyone we are doing. It's just a service we started, but we could see that the the kind of positive energy we gained through this positive learning and engagement. So please be part of this group and also support always. Thank you so much.
Thank you.